What can wash away my sins? Mm-hmm. Nothing but
being here today.
Amen.
And today is a special day, although a lot of people are just going by that day like it's nothing happened.
Yes.
But
that's
today
too bad.
I'll take you to the scripture reading. It's with Luke, the 23rd chapter.
All right.
Verse 43.
All right.
And it reads, and Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today thou shalt be with me in paradise. And we look at this, and the first word he did was forgive them, for they know not what they're doing.
Uh-huh.
Then Jesus moved on to his second word.
Come on now.
And here you can imagine Jesus being hung on the cross.
Man, Jesus.
And he hadn't did nothing. But
nothing. Hallelujah, Lord. Yes.
But on each side, he had a thief hanging there. And they know they was guilty. But Jesus took out his time as one began to say, Jesus, come down off the cross and save us.
Yes.
The thief knew who Jesus was.
Come on.
He realized that because he had heard about it. But he was not ready to repent of his sin.
My Jesus.
The other thief on the other side rebuked this man and said, we deserve what we get.
Come on.
But this man don't. And then he turned to Jesus and says, remember me. And that's all he had to say. So often we look at peoples and we think because peoples ain't living what they ought to be living or what we living.
Fix it up now.
Come
on, fix right, it up. Fix it, it up.
So often we said that there's no such thing as deathbed repentance.
All right. That's
day.
Right, that's right.
You know, you can't judge nobody.
Come on now, come on.
Often I hear people, when people die, oh, they didn't go to church.
Uh-huh.
They're like they're going to wind up in hell, but who is I to say?
That's right, that's
all
right.
All I got to do is treat you right.
Come on.
What God wants me to give you. It's up to God whether you make it in.
Bless the
and
Lord.
Everybody standing here today want to be in paradise.
That's right.
Yes, I don't know
yes.
What paradise is.
Come on now.
Hey. And another thing is we have funeral, we walk by the body just like that person is still there.
Yeah.
But if you listen to this, he told that thief today you will be with me in heaven.
Yes, come on
but
now.
That means that that body might be there.
Yeah, come
but
on.
That person is already gone.
Long gone. Yes.
You know, and I thank God that I ain't got to lay up in the funeral home for 7 or 8 days.
Yes.
And just that wandering around wondering what's going to happen.
Yes, preach.
But I die and breathe my life out. It goes back to God for
yes.
And that's all we need to realize.
Mm-hmm.
That it's more to life than just walking around here and then you die and the TV turn off. Life, you're going to have to give account for what you did in this body.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And the only thing you got to do is recognize that Jesus is who he say he is.
All right.
And then all you got to do is call upon him.
Yes.
You know, it ain't a whole lot of things. We get out here in different denominations, teach different things. You got to do this, you got to do that. You got to walk a certain way, you got to dress a certain way. But according to this, this thief didn't do none of that.
Come on now, come on now. Come on, preach.
And holler, Lord, remember me. So it let me know that everybody has got a chance.
Yes.
Whether it's on their deathbed or not, but I don't advise nobody to wait till you
that's the truth.
I know it's
you
right.
You don't know what kind of spirits you could die instantly and don't have time to say, Lord,
that's right.
So the day that you hear about Jesus, you need to come on down that aisle and give Jesus your life.
Yes.
It's work I got to do. And as we look around us in Lee County, the work is not getting done.
Ooh, Lord.
Yes.
You know, we can't stay shut up in the church.
That's right.
The church is out there.
Yes.
Jesus didn't come to those that already knew.
Come on.
He came to save those that didn't know.
Come on, preach.
And a lot of times we walk around, we look at people and they doing this and that, and we just condemn them and go on about our business.
Yes, yes.
But most of our churches need to be out there in the field.
Come on.
They need to be going about their Father's business.
Yeah, God.
That Jesus is the answer.
Yes, he is.
And if you don't believe, watch your TV. We're living in the last days.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
These days have come. And I know that I want to be in that new heaven and the new earth.
Want to be ready.
Tell
yes.
What Jesus allowed me to be in. I want to be
yes.
In.
Yes.
I don't want to be in hell lifting up my eyes.
Woo! That's right.
Ooh, and I'm going to tell you something. That's what a lot of us live like. That's what a lot of us don't. And There's a lot of church people that go to heaven.
Yeah, come on, come on.
It ain't gonna just be those right there, although that's what we say.
Yeah.
Some of us done got holier than thou.
Come on, preach.
And when God, you see a need, a lot of times we ain't got time to stop what we doing. If Jesus stopped down on the cross to save that
people, hallelujah.
What about us?
Mm. What about us?
How often do we stop and give somebody
tell it, tell it.
How often do we stop
yes,
and give somebody
Lord.
Encouragement from words?
Yes.
Most of the time we look at them and say, they ain't nobody.
My Lord, my
and
God.
Just keep going. We got children out there, and now you don't hurt to stop and talk to them.
Yeah.
Give them an encouragement word because you don't know what they're going through or what they're living through. Mm-hmm. And as we look around, people are killing each other every day.
All yes. day. Yeah.
People's in cahoots, they're doing it to children, and they're yes. innocent. So the thing is, we need to ask ourselves, where do I want to spend eternity?
Uh-huh.
Do I want to spend it here on earth? A lot of us is living like we're going to be here forever. We're building up mansions.
Tell it, tell it,
tell it.
We living like we not gonna never leave this earth.
Mm. My Lord,
but
my God.
I'll tell you something. If you live a little longer and die, somebody else gonna own what you own.
Yes.
Somebody
yes. yes.
And if you leave it to your children, they gonna sell
it. Tear it up.
And I see that with most older people.
Yes, that's the truth.
Their children take their stuff like it ain't no value.
Yes.
Amen. But one thing we need to take is life at face value.
Yes,
if
Lord.
Jesus can stop what he's doing on the cross to save somebody.
Bless you,
we
Jesus.
We can stop our life and give somebody
yes,
God,
yes.
So I
Amen.
Ask you first, what do you want to spend eternity on?
All right, all right.
Do you want to be in paradise or do you want to be in hell?
Ooh.
And as we leave here today, knowing that it's coming up to the getting up morning, that
uh-huh.
Jesus rose. We need to ask ourselves, where would I spend eternity? I can't answer for you.
Yes.
But I know where I'm going to be.
Yes.
And as Jesus said, today you shall be with me in paradise.
Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Ooh.
All right. All
yeah,
right.
God. Praise him.
That's good. Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah. Praise him.
Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
I don't like a quiet church. I just don't like it. When we be quiet on the Lord, I think we've been quiet and want to be mumble a little bit, we're taken from the Lord.
Yes.
So I'm going to do this one more again. Praise the Lord, church.
Praise him. Hallelujah.
All right.
Amen.
So much better.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Pastor Garner.
Amen.
Apostle Garner.
Yes, yes.
And the pastor of this wonderful church.
Praise you, Jesus.
First of all, thank you for inviting me.
You're welcome.
I thank God also that I have this opportunity to stand before you.
Amen.
Tell you what thus says the word.
And amen.
If you don't mind, I called a friend because I kind of didn't want to come by myself.
All right.
And I called her and she was busy. But I have to say thank you if you don't mind.
Yes, go Callie, for it.
Thank you so much for coming.
Amen.
It feels good when
it
somebody
does.
Loves you enough to come.
Amen.
To
amen.
You know, I know wherever I go, God's there first. Amen.
Yes, yes. Come on now.
So that wasn't a big part.
All right.
Still just coming to somebody that I know that's going
amen.
To be here. And I am so delighted that
yes, Lord.
I get to say what she gave me to say.
Hallelujah,
and you know,
Jesus.
When somebody gives you something to say and it makes you study.
All right.
It makes you study, it makes
yes.
you dig.
Yes.
That's a sign of God trying to tell you you're going to learn more and he's taking you to a
yes.
higher level.
Yes, he is.
And that's what I'm walking this walk with God so he can take me to a higher
come
level.
Come on with it. Yes.
Anyway, first of all, Lord God, I just want to say thank you for
yes.
this blessed day. Father, I ask you not only, Lord God, this program and talking about the children.
Lord
God, you already know all about it. But Lord God, I'm just asking you right now, Lord
hallelujah.
God.
Hallelujah.
They may see me, Lord God. But don't let them hear me, Lord God.
Ooh,
let them hear you, Lord God.
Ooh,
that
Lord.
Whatever come out of my mouth, Lord God, be about you. Because, Lord God,
yes.
I am about my Father's business.
Oh,
in
thank
Jesus
you, Jesus.
Name, and also, in the absence of my pastor,
all right now,
a gardener, and I am from the Bunker Hill Baptist Church.
Amen.
And it says, when Jesus therefore saw his mother,
yes,
and the disciple standing by whom he loved,
yes,
remember that now, whom he loved, that's very important.
Okay.
Whom he loved, the disciple, whom he loved, he said, I'm mother.
Yes.
Woman, behold thy son. And son. But while he was hanging on the cross, obeying the Father,
bless his name,
to perform the duty which he owed as a son.
Yes, come on, fix it.
We too must learn to give preference to the command, the worship, the service of God, after which, as far as we are able, but must first give man what is due.
All right.
In other words, we got to first serve God.
Amen.
No matter what we do, how we do, and when we do,
say
God,
it. Say it. All right.
And give man what he
come on.
All right. Tell it. Tell
even
it.
Your parents.
Uh-huh.
You got to think, okay, my mama said. But
say
what
it.
Did God say do?
All right.
We got to do what God said. He said.
All right.
God said, not me. He who loveth the father or the mother more than me.
Preach. Good one.
Not even worthy of me.
Amen.
That comes from Matthew. It didn't come from me. Matthew 24. Christ attends to his mother, but it is after he's on the cross. He knew when he was walking. You know what? While he was walking and taking all those beatings and those bad words. That
come on, come on.
And the spit on him, all that ugly stuff that was done. You know, God knew his mother was right there. He saw his mother, but he still didn't take time out right then for his mother. He had to do what God said do.
All right,
God man. Had gave him a decree that you got to do this here. You got to be on the cross. So after he had been called by his father's decree, this passenger that we're just talking about, how he obeyed his father.
Yes,
he shows the honor which God, by the law,
come on
God
now.
Says, honor thy mother and thy father.
Bless the Lord.
He also
good word.
Surrendered to the parents. Exodus 20:12. But then he looked back and he chose a disciple.
Yes.
Not just a disciple.
Come on.
But a disciple whom he loved.
Yes.
To be a substitute. A substitute. And he sent out a charge.
Hallelujah. Preach.
A charge. And when a charge is sent out to you,
yes.
That means that's what you do.
Hallelujah. Yes.
So he sent out a charge and to the disciple to support and take
hallelujah.
Care of his mother, showing the honor.
Yes.
He is due to the parents.
Hallelujah,
not
Jesus.
A cold ceremony, which a cold ceremony
hallelujah.
Could be just simply take care of my mom. You see my mama there. You know that's my mama. Take care of my mama. But he didn't do it like that. He gave a charge. And when he was discharging all of the necessary duties that a son does as his mother.
Bless the Lord.
As he says, woman, not mother, behold thy son.
All right.
And I know it kind of puzzled me. I don't know about y'all, but it kind of puzzled me why he said woman. But we're going to get to that.
All right.
But anyway, he said, woman, behold thy son. In other words, I shall not be inhabited on this earth. So I discharge this man. Himself. Duties of a son.
Yes.
But he turned around saying to John. Behold thy mother.
Yay, God.
For by these words, he charges John, the disciple, whom he loved.
Bless the Lord.
He charged him with the word saying, treat her as a mother.
Yes.
And care for her.
Hallelujah.
And you would do your own
yes.
Mother. All right.
And the reason for not mentioning his mother's name is just simply, and when he calling her woman. Y'all gotta realize now, when he was walking, carrying the cross, he was still flesh.
Yes.
All right. He got on the cross. He was not flesh no more.
He was transforming, yes.
He was transforming.
Hallelujah.
What God had gave him a decree to do.
Yay.
So during the transformation.
Yes.
It was woman.
Yes.
But before that, it was mother.
Mother.
But see, when he started transforming, it all of us was mother.
Yes.
All of us was his children.
Yes.
So he just simply said, woman. Christ had completed the course, as I said, the human course of the human life where he has a mother. But he lays down the condition in which he had lived, and he starts entering
Come on.
The heavenly kingdom.
Come on.
So he is no longer flesh.
Yes.
See, we got to take it where it wasn't he was not being disrespectful.
No.
He's not a man. He's not a man like that.
Come on now.
When he was walking the earth, he was not disrespectful.
Bless
him. So it was not that he was being disrespectful. It was just the part and he was still doing God's work.
Yes, yes.
He was doing what he was called to do.
Hallelujah.
He had already performed his job as a son. While he was here on earth.
Yes.
When she went looking for him, he said, what did he say? Mother, why do you look for me? I'm doing my father's business.
Uh-huh.
But he was still walking the earth as a human life.
Yes.
And once he knew that he was going to go into the heavenly kingdom, it was a transformation.
Yeah,
like
God.
Us, let me tell you, we have to transform. When God called you
speak
to do his work, there's a transformation that each one has to take on.
All right.
You may not see it, but I'm telling you, sometimes you don't even see it yourself.
Yes.
Somebody will come and say, oh, you sure look different.
Uh-huh.
And you know what?
That's right.
Girl, you got to go about yourself.
Uh-huh.
And you know what I'm trying to say? Girl, it's the grace of God.
Yes,
it's
yes.
The grace of God.
Yes.
Because only God can bring a heathen.
Uh-huh.
A thief.
Come on now.
A drug addict.
Come on.
Like me.
All right.
To serve him.
Yeah.
To serve
Preach.
Him. Only God can take this dirty, filthy, rag person.
All right.
And make a great creation.
So hey. Hey.
Tell people about he has, not only he has died for us, for our sin, because it wasn't for our sin, he wouldn't have
Hallelujah.
Died.
Hallelujah.
But he died on that
Hallelujah.
Cross, hanging there, taking all our sins on his shoulder, so we will have a chance
yeah.
at eternal life.
Hallelujah.
He said, you don't have to. You know what's so good about it?
Hallelujah.
You can have eternal life through him right here on earth.
Yeah.
You can have paradise right here on earth.
Yes.
Because he said, whatever you ask for in his name.
Yeah, preach.
Shall be given.
Yes.
Because he said he is rich.
Yes.
He is rich. Think about it. All the hills, if he got cows on all these hills.
Yes.
If you got a street paved in gold,
uh-huh.
Y'all, what are we a destitute about?
Come on now.
You don't have to be.
Amen.
You don't have to be.
Bless his
you know,
name.
I probably should have stood up because right now it's on my mind. But when we first got here, I got started and we was talking about it and I saw your steps.
All right.
And I said, oh Lord, I can't do steps. That's a lot of steps. But I said, okay, Lord, with you. I can climb those steps.
Come on now. Come on.
And I climbed those steps. I was tired, but I climbed those steps.
Yes.
But a year ago.
All right.
But a year ago.
Come on. Hey.
I was in a wheelchair.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to tell you, I was in a wheelchair because.
Yes.
Satan played with me.
All right.
Through a doctor. Satan played with me.
All right.
You know what? Satan thought he was going to hold me down. That's why I can tell you how good God is.
Yes.
He was going to hold me down when he allowed that doctor to play with my body where I would not be able to walk. Instead of being in the hospital for 3 days like he said I was going to be, I was in the hospital for 3 months plus.
Jesus.
And still came Ooh. Out with a wheelchair and a hospital bed.
My nobody Lord.
Tell me, God did not die for me.
Yeah.
So I will be able to tell y'all how
yes.
good he is.
Yes.
He will change your life. Just
Hallelujah.
Like the transformation, that's part of your transformation.
Yes, it
you
is.
Think, you know what? When you have problems
Preach.
And you think your bills is all piling up.
All right.
And you don't see no end in me. I'm going to tell you, God will show you a way.
Yes, he will.
God will tell you, I make you a way out of no way.
That's
part of your transformation.
Yes.
But you know that transformation got to do with faith.
Yes.
You know they say hope, but hope is faith.
Yes.
And if you don't have that faith to keep walking, you're going to fall.
All right.
You're going to fall. But each day you walk with God, your faith builds higher and higher
Come
and
on.
Higher. That's part of your transformation. Your transformation is growing in God. He transferred to go to heaven for us so we will have unspeakable joy.
Yes.
Unspeakable joy.
Full of glory.
And when I tell you about unspeakable joy, it doesn't matter.
Yes.
This right man was talking about how he had to eulogize his mother.
Yes.
His mother. But he said he was all right with it. You know why? Because you've got God in your heart. And anytime you believe in God, he will bring you joy in the midst of sorrow.
Yes.
That's a part of your transformation.
Yes.
He transformated from this earth to heaven. For a wretch like me.
Amen.
I can't say for you.
Hey, Jesus. Yes.
But I can tell you,
preach.
Like me. He transformed it that way. He did what God had decreed him to do.
Bless
you. He did not really want to do it. Remember that. But that's something for you to read yourself. But I just want you to know, he did all of that. He did what God told him to do as that decree.
Yes.
But even through all that pain and suffering and everything else, he forgot about it for one minute and made sure that his mom was taken care of.
Hallelujah.
And you know what? If you keep reading, you'll find out, and you study it, you'll find out when he told John never said a mumbling word.
Mm-hmm.
Hey. John just took his mama to his home.
That's right.
Now, it never said that his disciples had a home. Did it ever say that?
No.
But when you study, you find out John was rich. He had a home.
Yes.
Where he could take care of his new mother.
Yes.
God is not going to put you in a place that he cannot prepare you for.
All right.
If God tells you to do something, he already got it set.
Hallelujah. Tell it.
See, he told John to do something. He knew John had the ability. And he loved John, and John loved him. So when you love somebody like that, your love is going to grow.
Yes,
you got the love of God.
Amen.
Y'all pray my strength and love.
Amen.
Pray for y'all.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. I just got